Hi students, coming to our next topic, that is the instruction cycle. So before going to learn about the instruction cycle, you have to know the concept of program. So actually where this program will be present? A program is resides in a memory unit which consisting of sequence of instructions. So this program will be present in the memory unit. This program is in the form of sequence of instructions. So always the program will be stored in the memory unit in the form of sequence of instructions. So each instruction will be read from the memory unit and will be executed with the help of instruction cycle, in the form of instruction cycle. Each instruction will be executed in the form of instruction cycle phases. Here in a basic computer, each instruction cycle consists of fetch, decode, execute. So in between that, if you are having any effective address, decision will be taken in the effective address. So instruction cycle is having three phases: fetch, decode and execute. So fetch is used to fetch the data from memory unit. After fetching the data, that will be decoded in the decoded phase. After decoding, it reads the effective address from memory of instruction if it is indirect address. Suppose the instruction, whatever it is present in the instruction register, if I is 0, it indicates direct addressing. We already discussed it. I is the 15th bit in the instruction register. So this is the instruction register. So this is the 15th bit, indicates the I. And 14, 13, 12 indicates the opcode. Operation has to be performed. From 11 to 0 is the holds the address. So this we already discussed in the previous slide. So here the I indicates if it is 0, no need to go for the decision, it directly executes the instruction. If I is 1, means indirect addressing mode. So if it is I is 1, then we have to read the effective address from memory of instruction. We have to read the effective address from memory. So this is the instruction cycle. So let us see how the instruction cycle will be executed in the form of a flowchart. So before going to discuss the flowchart, let us see the steps that are coming in the flowchart. So first step is we have to start the program. So when we'll start the program, whenever the sequence counter will be 0. So sequence counter is 0 means the timing pulse starts from T0. So at the time of T0, step 2. So during the timing sequence T0, the program counter will be placed in the address register. So what address register contains, whatever the address that is present in the program counter, that will be placed in the address register. Program counter is nothing but the address of the next instruction to be executed, that will be stored in the program counter. So in the next step, during T1. So in T1 timing signal, the content of memory address of the address register will be placed in the instruction register. After that, memory will be placed in the instruction register. Now the instruction register holds the opcode, the operation that has to be performed, and the program counter will be incremented by 1. Means the next instruction that has to be executed, that will be stored in program counter. So whenever the operation is over, again it takes the instructions which will be incremented by 1. In that location will be transferred to address register, and the content of that address, the operation that has to be performed, will be moved to the instruction register. So this everything will be done at timing signal T1. So this during T0 and T1, we are just fetching the data from memory. So this is the fetch cycle. So you are just fetching the data from memory. Now coming to next step, step 4. So during T2, during the timing pulse T2, timing signal T2, what the instruction will doing. So this is the after fetch, we have to decode the instruction. We have to convert whatever the instruction that we are fetching from memory. So decode, first you have to decode the opcode. So where will be the opcode is present? The opcode is present in instruction register. So from 12 to 14 bits, the opcode will be there. So this is the opcode, 12 to 14 bits. So this will be decoded. Decode opcode in the instruction register. After that, the 0 to 11 bits, which holds the address, that will be placed in the address register. Then I indicates the 15th bit, whether it is 1 or 0, that will be decided based on the instruction that is given. So if it is 1, it is indirect. 0, you have to perform the direct addressing. So this is the decode section. So whatever the data that is fetched from memory, that will be decoded. Now coming to the step 5. So after that decode, we have to execute the decoded instruction. So before execution, we have to check whether it is a direct address or indirect address. So this is a decision taken place in this timing signal. So if it is actually the instruction register, the whatever the data instruction that we will taken from memory will be of 3 types. So the instruction may be a memory reference instruction, register reference instruction, or input output reference instruction. So the instruction whatever we are getting from memory may be a memory reference instruction, register reference instruction, or IO reference instruction. So these instructions will be, means we have to the D7 bit will decide the type of instruction, whether it is a memory reference, register reference, or IO reference. So this everything will be seen in the flowchart. So during T3, if it is not a direct addressing, means if T3 is indirect, the execution will be taken at T4. If it is direct, the execution will be directly taking place at T3 cycle itself. So let us see the flowchart of this instruction cycle. So this is the flowchart of the instruction cycle. Here you have seen the start sequence counter to 0. So we have to start this instruction fetch, decode, and execute with the starting step. That is, the sequence counter has to be cleared to 0. So whenever it is cleared to 0, the pulse will start from T0. So during T0, the program counter will be placed in the address register. And after T1 pulse, means the pulse will be, timing signals will be incremented one by one. So during T1, the program the memory address register, the address register memory reference will be placed in the instruction register. After that, the program counter has to be incremented by 1. So, means it is going moving to the next memory location. That will be stored in address register. So, here the memory will be whatever the operation that has to be performed, that will be moved to the instruction register. So, this everything will be done in the fetch cycle. Now, coming to the decode. After fetching the data from memory, so memory you have to fetch the instruction. After fetching, you have to be decode. So what we have to be decode? So whatever the data that is present in the opcode, operation has to be performed. So I already said, so instruction register is of 16 bit register. So here the 15th bit indicates the I. So it decides whether it is a direct address or indirect address. And 14, 13, 12, it indicates the opcode, the decoded opcode. Operation has to be performed, will be placed in 14, 13, 12. And from 11 to 0, address will be stored. So here, decode opcode means the operation has to be performed, will be placed in instruction register 12 to 14. And 0 to 11 is the address will be placed in the address register. And the 15th bit of I in the instruction register will be placed in I. So now coming to the after decoding, we have to execute the program. So before executing the program, we have to check whether the data is direct or indirect. So coming to the D7. So actually this 14, 13, 12 is from, it's a 3 bit 0 to 1, 1, 1 will be there. So this is the D7. So D7 it is nothing but 1. So here if it is 1, it is nothing but memory or, sorry, register or IO. So if suppose D7 is 1, it may be a register reference or IO reference instruction. Whether it is 0, it compulsory it should be a memory reference. 0 means any one of this from up to here, from 00 to 110 means D6. These are all allocated to memory reference. And the last one is the whether it is a register reference or IO reference. So I already said the instruction is of 3 types. Memory reference, IO reference, register reference. First, we have to decide which instruction is it. Is it a memory reference, IO reference or register reference? We have to decide. So, this is the decision place. So, suppose if you take, it is a memory reference, means from 0 to 110. So, okay, the instruction is a memory reference. It is in between these instructions. So, if the I, now check I. Whether this I is direct or indirect. Suppose it is direct. Direct means suppose memory reference direct. Means direct means 0. 0. This is 15th bit. It is 0. And it should be in between 00 to 110. Anything. 14, 13, 12. This bit be anything, and the remaining is the address. So if it is 0, nothing we have to be do. Directly you have to execute the memory instruction and you make the sequence counter to clear to 0, because you execute the instruction. After executing the instruction, again the cycle will starts from T0. Suppose it is 1. Suppose this is 1, means this is 1. So what we have to do, if it is 1, we have to be convert, means you have to take the effective address register in AR, then you have to execute the memory instruction. Means you have to take the data from effective address register and then you have to execute the memory reference instruction and make the sequence counter to 0. So this is about memory reference. Now coming to the register reference or IO reference. Suppose D7 is 1, means this is the last bit, D7 is 1. If D7 is 1, suppose the last bit is 0, means what? If the last bit is 0, means 15th bit is 0 and 14, 13, 12 or 1, 1, 1 and the remaining are the register operations. Okay, if it is like this, the instruction is like this, then you have to execute register reference instruction and make sequence counter to 0. Suppose if it is the I is 1 and then opcode is 111 and the register operations, then you have to be execute input output instructions and make sequence counter to 0. Again you have to start the next cycle. So this is how the instruction will be executed internally. So this is the instruction cycle. So 1, start, fetch, decode, execute, and again you are taking the next instruction. This complete cycle, you call it as a machine cycle. This complete cycle, you call it as a machine cycle. One machine cycle means fetching the data, decoding the data, execute, and again taking another data. That complete cycle, you call it as a machine cycle. And in between that fetch, decode and execute, you call it as a instruction cycle. Thank you.